Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I've been promoting Chris's RTR block drafts. I have done standard pauper, I've done standard, I've done two pauper chats in a few days here now. But I can't stay away from my real poison. You see what this is? You have read the headline. Oh yes, I'm going back in. The boosters are now 259, so there is a sale on M13 draft. And I am buying! Hopefully it's filling. If you listen to the latest episode of Limited Resources, I think it's 183, a discussion with Zach Hill. Zach Hill was actually the lead developer of M13, and he talks a bit about M13 and what he tried to accomplish, and I think he succeeded. What he wanted to do was a set that could seem extremely simple and be an introduction to Magic, or perhaps the next step in introduction to Magic after Duel of the Planeswalkers, but still contain complicated concepts for advanced players. And he wanted a set that could be drafted 100 times without getting bored, and I'm getting close to drafting 100 times, not to getting bored. I love the set. It's great. With the falling prices of M13, I want to have MTG Goldfish available with some prices. Tragtusk is still at 9, but Thundermoor Hellcat has fallen down to 20. Jace is at 10. Garuk at 15, yeah. Even the lands are falling, except Rupankrag, that is at 250. So let's do this! Let's play some Magic 2013! Come on! I don't know if that helps. It's a way to get rid of frustration. Ajani 554, Akroma's Memorial 165, Chandra 373, Elder Scale Worm 129, Garuk 1507, Liliana 678, Nicol Bolas 4, Omniscience 497, Primordial Hydra $5. It used to be like 1. So next time I'm picking up Primordial Hydras if they reprint it, but there was another Hydra in the M14 spoiler. I think M14 looks really good. So I will be playing some M14. And I, as I said, I've given up on RTR block. I have two Ravnica boosters and they are the hard to get. So I might play those, but then again I might not. Because Modern Masters is around the corner. I suppose drafting Modern Masters will be a bit corsetty, and I love that. And then there'll be M14. It's not far now. One more drafter, come on! One drafter, one time. Thundermoor Hellkite, one time. Oh, Jace is still my favorite card in the set. Maybe it's not my favorite card, but it is the best card. It's much more fun to win with Garuk, but Jace is just a better card. And I wouldn't place Thundermoor Hellkite anywhere near them in power level. Also, the Angel is a lot more powerful than Thundermoor Hellkite. Though Thundermoor Hellkite is not in any way bad. So, are we doing this or what? Check out this, by the way. New episode of Pauper to the People, episode 110. They discuss a VR control build that must be Boros Kitty. And we are about to play some M13. I'm gonna stand up. And this is... my experience tells me that Volcanic Gazer is the better card, but red is the worst color, and you really want to be You want to be the guy with the disciple of Bolas. That's what you want to be in this set. And I will just pick it. Disciple of Bolas, I'm going into black. Will be great. Passing a lot of red stuff. There is a black ring as well, though I don't care very much about that. There is a murder to keep me going. The thing is that there are other cards in this pack as well. And I would love to have this pack leader to go with my disciple. That sounds close to broken. This Voidstalker is really good. Perhaps even better than murder, but I am gonna take the murder to keep black coming. And now I run out of black and I get two excellent cards here. I think this might be the day I go into blue-black. Cause Talaran's Invocation is a little stronger than Armstealer, not a lot. But I love black-red. And I might regret this. But no, they are sending me a third pack Talaran's Invocation. That means that they are not taking blue. So I am taking it. But what road do I end up on then? And crust. It's just so bad. Guardian, just so good. Being black-white exalted with the Disciple of Bolas is just broken. Though having an Entrancer here. But Entrancer is not something that goes to Disciple of Bolas. I'm gonna stay open here. That is, get confused and pick new colors. Stormtide Leviathan. Bloodhunter Bat is just the safer thing. But maybe this is the day I build for Stormtide Leviathan. I got it early. I can build a defensive deck. I have the Talaran's Invocation. Imagine Disciple of Bolasing this guy. Ah, I'm gonna do it. Okay, I am blue-black. I must find Exalted Guys to go with the Disciple of Bolas, because this will be the deck where Disciple of Bolas is at its worst. They are sending me the green stuff. Another pack leader! My god! Jesus! How do I defend against that? And now I'm suddenly becoming really blue. I'm picking the Guardians here as well. I might splash them. Stupid rare. Well, black really dried up. So if I play Harbor Serpent main deck here, I could actually disciple him for some real value. But I need Exalted Guys now. That is what I need the most. Or someone like... what's his name? The Pumpable, the tree drop. The blue one. Watercourser. To use the disciple. Maybe I should just not obsess as much about the disciple. Let's see what comes in the second pack. Well, okay, now I'm going to be obsessed with Talrand and his invocation. I am taking Talrand here, and I will need to pick up instants and stuff. There is a nice instant. I hear that is playable. Archaeomancers are now becoming attractive, though I will need to have 8 or 9 instants for those. Hopefully, like 8 or 9 murders maybe. Well, I did cut black pretty hard, so I should be getting black and blue cards from my side here. Healer of the Pride, but I am not going to consider splashing, and I think what will help me live here is Bloodhunter Bat, more than Duty Bound Dead. I like Duty Bound Dead, but I'm gonna pick the Bloodhunter Bat here. But look at the casting costs on my deck. I have a problem. And here I have a Greed incentive. Drowned Catacomb is only 78. But it's great, and the Velkin turn is also great, of course. And maybe a good deck would play the Velkin turn and not the Drowned Catacomb. I do want to win, so I'm picking the Velkin turn. I hate Tricks of the Trade. I hate all the cards here. I am value picking the Ground Seal, because that has randomly risen in value a lot. It was at 174, it's now at 1. What the hell? They really want me to splash white. And I have 2 solid white cards here, but the walls... But I'm deep enough not to splash. I need the 2 drops. Need them so bad. Rise from grave. Well, it's gonna be Unsummon. Yeah, I don't think I need to splash anything here. So what am I looking for now? I'm looking for Archaeomancers, absolutely. More spells and instants. Though not crappy ones like Index. I'm going to pick the Erase for my sideboard, as I clearly could splash white if I really needed to. Wow. No, I'm not gonna let somebody Primadox me to death. There is not a playable card in this pack. And Divine Favor is probably never a sideboard card. Never, never, ever, never play Downpour. It's not worth a card. Maybe Smelt will be one day. Picking that Duress for my sideboard. Picking that Duress for my sideboard too. And even though I really want Sorcerers and Instants, I'm not gonna play the rest, because it's just too big a chance of missing. Now I will get to pick up more blue cards. And I hope they are Unsummons. I hope they are Switcheroos. And Archaeomancers. And Stormtide Leviathan. Without reliable card draw, and I still haven't got any reliable card draw, is definitely an 18 mana card. And even with 18 mana, I will on the average play him on a very, very late turn. Spelltwine, that's all very good and nice, and it looks like it works, but it doesn't. Essence Drain is an instant and a removal as well, but I will not pick a second tier removal over this monster, this creature of the night, this killer of men and titans, Chronomaton! Somebody's passing me Predatory Rampage, and I think I can't allow Predatory Rampage to be in the draft. I will lose to it. It's foil. Does that mean anything? Probably not. There is a Velkin turn here that I would like, but no, I'm not gonna let them have this. There's my water courser, but I'm not excited. I'm not getting what I wanted here. I thought this would be my blue pack. Knight of Glory. Wow. Liliana Shade is of course really good with the Stormtide. And I only need 22 playables to make this happen. Definitely need more instants and sorceries, but right now we don't have any card that really demands it. This is currently then 14 creatures and 4 instants and sorceries. And we really don't have any good targets for the... Sign in Blood or Worldfire. I just like Worldfire. It's fun. It's 88 cents. Is it worth 88 cents? I think it's probably better to have a Sign in Blood to get to my land. To be able to play my Stormtide Leviathan. I will happily cut the Harbor Serpent if I find something better. I would like fog banks and stuff to hide behind to make the game go longer. Because right now, one part of my deck wants to race with Windrakes and Velkin turns, and one part of my deck wants to just hide behind anything to make enable the Stormtide Leviathan. But Bloodhunter Bat kind of does both. Lots of 4-drops. And I think I'm gonna disciple a 2-2 creature, and that's okay. You really want to do it to 3-3 creatures. I think Mark of the Vampire is a card that will help me survive. That's why I'm gonna play it. Wow, another Healer of the Pride. Well, you can't play Blood Throne. And we did need a sorcery, so this is a deck. It's not a very good deck. We only have 5 black creatures, though the black ring could be used for regeneration. We will now test the black ring. But then we need to cut something. But I like the interaction of the white ring and... the Disciple, though that is pretty far-fetched. Oh, maybe. Well, the more I look at it, the more I'm gonna cut the black ring. The black ring or Mind Rot. Well, the black ring can protect... I can hide behind the black ring, actually, on the blue guy. And I have 15 guys. So I think I'm actually cutting Mind Rot here, as I didn't get an Archaeomancer. And that way, this would be my deck. It has 15 guys, 5 sorceries instants, and the ring and the mark of the vampire. And it's a very defensive control deck that wants to set up the Stormtide Leviathan and then win with that. We should do well against other control decks with two Resses. And we know from earlier experience that even when Disciple of Bola seems bad, he's really good. But is this the optimal choice of creatures? Or would I rather just play Mindrot than the Harbor Serpent? The Harbor Serpent is a great stabilizer though. And just a huge dude that will be standing in the way of everything. Maybe it is Mindrot. Mindrot on Talrand. I think it's Mindrot. Nine, really? Well, I should be hitting three islands long before I hit the eight land. I have lost count on my M13 drafts. I'm just a drug addict. Did I do 35? Or didn't I? I did 34, so this is, I had 21 views! Yay! So you guys are probably getting bored. About this, but I'm not. So just skip the videos if you don't like them. Blue-black, submitting. Another reason to run 18 land is that I really, really have to hit 4 mana with this stupid curve. And I should be easily overrun by quick decks. But the Harbor Serpent don't help me a lot there. I think my greatest enemy will be super fast decks, like the black-red, the red-white decks. I might have game against green deck. And also a better Flyers deck should crush me. Somebody was definitely picking blue. I didn't get as much nice stuff that I wanted. As Talon's Invocation can easily be counted as a creature, this is a 15 creature deck. My spells are pretty good, though I only have 2 removal spells. I am relying then on superiority in the air, milling somebody with the Entrancer, hiding behind the ring or the Chronomaton. I think I should have air superiority, but against something like a Griffin, it will be hard to have air superiority. Without the mark. Against the blue deck, I'll probably sideboard out the mark of the vampire so I don't get 2-for-1 and bring in the Harbor Serpent. Watercourser, great guy to Bloodhunt, to Disciple. But we didn't get one Exalted guy. So we are reliant to get a high score on the Disciple. We are reliant on maybe Liliana Shade or the Black Ring or the Watercourser. Disciple for 4 on the Watercoursers, that's probably game. And I will I tell you what high score is. High score is Stormtide Leviathan who gets pacified, and then I can maybe I shouldn't sacrifice it even if it's pacified. So let's see how it goes. Having said all this about blue decks, the only card of first pick quality in my deck that is blue is Talrand's Invocation. I rate Sky Summoner as a second to fourth pick, and Stormtide Leviathan as a third to fifth pick. But I got the Stormtide Leviathan early, so I could build around him. And I even built a bit around the Sky Summoner, so they are better than the same, even if I'm a bit light on sorceries. It seems somebody is not here, or is not submitting a deck. We're getting close. I'll tell you one thing with drafting a format this many times. This is the first time I ever drafted something 80 drafts. Is that you get so many cards. What do you do with all of them? It's like, I happened to sell a bit of Knight and Infamy for 1 cent each, because I was so happy that people were taking them, or bots were taking them, and I figured, this card is probably worth more than 1 cent. Okay, here we go! Woohoo! Yeah, stuff is falling down. It's the Angry Probe! And he will be angry because we will crush him. We want to play first. And you might think this is a deck that doesn't want to play first, but actually every deck wants to play first in this format. And but we have 18 lands, we get to play the Windrake, the Ring. Oh, we have the Stormtide Leviathan as well. I think we have to throw this back. Yeah, this is a much better hand. We are keeping that. It's actually a super hand if we draw land now. And we do. So now we can begin to put pressure on him with the Velkin turn. And he has a stop set in my draw phase. That's not a sign of greatness. Because this match might last long. I'm gonna sign in blood next turn. And I'm trusting my Blood Hunter bat to help me to race here. But if he plays like a Timberpack Wolf, the race is on. This is me just gulping down coffee to stay awake. Because all these drugs, man, they wear on you. It's Timberpack Wolf! And I'm gonna assist him in the race by playing the wrong land. That's interesting. Okay, focus. Centaur Courser means that I'm taking 5 next turn then. Which is really bad. So I think we are trading with the Centaur Courser. As our course of action. Taking nothing instead. Or is that so wise? Do we want to take 5 damage? To get the Shade into play. Or actually the bat. Anyway, we are attacking here. Going to 13 will put me on the defensive. But I think getting more mana into play in the long run will be a winning thing to do. Though if his secondary color now is something that can deal with the one toughness creature, then I have a problem. Okay, now I must establish ground control. And maybe I can. Oh, stupid ring. But he didn't equip the ring. Why didn't he? I think the correct play now is to attack and to play the Water Courser. Threatening an activation of that to 3, which is a very bad trade for him to make. forcing him to waste an entire turn here. He's going for like a pack leader or something. Or a spider. And of course, a spider, a sentinel spider, will be really bad for us. But if he doesn't attack this turn, it's really good for us. And that's of course horrible. Preapon gives green that thing they have lacked. He still can't really attack. So what do? I can't block a 4-4, can I? Maybe I can. Let's draw cards for options. Okay, the plan now is just to play Bloodhunter Bats, basically. And trade with Water Courser, and yep, that's what we're gonna do. To get the Flying Beats going again. The centaur has trample, and I think I need to block him now with the Water Courser and the Bloodhunter Bat. And he is... Oh my god! Mark of the Vampire. Well, I'm not blocking that. Well, let's put the plan into action, as I said. Or even use the shade. We can get the shade to 4 and use... No, we have to use the Water Courser. So we'll swing with the Water Courser and the Bloodhunter Bat. And even the shade. No, we can't afford swinging with... the shade. So we pump. We pump. Hitting for 6. Disciple into Water Courser. And then... and then what? Oh, we gain 4 lives as well. So we need now to... Well, we're actually doing a lot of damage here. Oh, but he has lifelink, of course, so that doesn't matter. We need to kill him and block him. And if he has Titanic Growth here, I'll pay for that information. Okay, so we need to block an 8-8. Please, Stormtide Leviathan one time! Okay, if he can kill this Stormtide Leviathan, I'm gonna lose the game. And he has plenty of time to kill it. No, he doesn't, because I have Island Walk. And this is why we play Stormtide Leviathan. I hit for 10, I have a 2-turn clock here. He might just concede here. Stormtide Leviathan. There is no text on the card that tells you a great story about who this fish is and why he's doing what he's doing. but obviously he's flooding the land so that the giant centaur courser and the arbor elf and the Garuk, something is happening! They are swimming around in the water, feeling bad. Here's another pack leader that helps him draw a card. But the time for drawing cards... Could we get enough guys onto the field to block? Probably not. If he kills the Leviathan, doom is upon us. Hutchling. Blood on the bat. And walking corpse. The centaur courser is now bigger than the Leviathan. Prey upon would suck. Yeah, Westwood Gorgers. I think I should play the Harbor Serpent against him. Because this is obviously gonna be a matchup of fat dudes. Or I could splash. Or I could play the Duress. No, he has too few sorceries and stuff. But I'm really vulnerable to the Mark of the Vampire. But I have murders, I have unsummon, etc. I should be fine. And that was a victory for Mr. Stormtide. So do I bring in Duress? It can be so bad. And what's not to like? And I could very well win with Welk in turn. He wasn't performing great, was he? And the ring is obviously really good here. Also Mind Rot, maybe Mind Rot for Duress. Oh, that just seems bad. Mind Rot for the Harbor Serpent. I think that's it, actually. Erase, melt, Duress, Wild Rebirth. No, this is what I'm gonna play. That's a decent hand, really. Just needs one more swamp. I'm not gonna mulligan. This is definitely a racing hand. And I'm gonna play the Welk in turn, then the Windrake. Ooh. Yay! I have a long term plan as well. And I hope you saw that the card that won the match wasn't Stormtide Leviathan. Or it was Stormtide Leviathan, but it was definitely Disciple of Bolas. Oh, he kept the one lander. My god. He did keep a one lander. Ouch. The thing is that many two-landers you should mulligan, and you should always in M13 mulligan a two-lander, because keeping a one-lander is just too greedy. It doesn't work. Six card hands are not that bad, and now he has five turns to live, and I'm really not afraid of anything he can do now in black. course he needs to stop these two flyers. And his ground assault just got stopped by Water Courser, who is also setting up another Disciple of Bolas combo. But he's drawing mana like a boss. I think unless I draw the mana, I need to get Chronomaton out now. Because he needs to do his thing. And he is of course the best Disciple target. Another Drake. Well, that is better. So now it's a two-turn clock, and it's a classic Flyers win. Maybe. Unless he gets Sentinel Spider. No, Sentinel Spider is too slow. Essence Drain can still save him. Do I would feel more comfortable if I had that next black mana? And I do not want to draw Storm Tide Leviathan at this point. Oh no, it's a giant centaur! And this is why I don't like the Force Mage a lot. Okay, I'll just kill the... Walking Corpse. Is there a kill there for me? Can he kill me next turn? I highly doubt it. But I'm gonna play safe and play Chronomaton Murder. I did draw the land there. I did draw the land I needed, the swamp, so I'm excited about that. So we are blocking here. We are blocking the... that guy. Double Timber Pack. But I am just flying in for the win. Like the RAF in 1945. And we begin this journey with blue-black. With 2-0, and everybody else is done. Because they're not making videos. And everybody else is done with 2-0. I rush for coffee. Did you miss me? I should just have paused, sorry. So here we are, together with Jay Duncan, Living Legend, and Astroth 16 into the second round of the Swiss draft in the 0-1-0 bracket. And we are going to win. I hope. I don't recognize any of these guys, and I do recognize a lot of M13 Swiss drafters. I play Swiss drafts all the time, and I only play Swiss drafts because I like to play Magic, and I like to win. And you get to do both in Swiss drafts. And here we go, it's the Living Legend. And it's Living Legend 26. I do want to play first. And we have learned there that Stormtide Leviathan and two mana. This is a six card hand already. But it's a pretty decent six card hand, isn't it? I am going to keep it because I just need to draw one and to be able to play all my spells but the Stormtide Leviathan. But I only have two chances to draw the land before it becomes a problem. Luckily he plays a mulligan card. You should never ever ever play that card. But I'm going to get stuck on two mana against the blue deck. Against the black blue deck even. So Harbor Serpent is gonna be sadly missed. My god! Missing the land drop there, but I took the risk. I bought the ticket, now I'm gonna take the ride. If he plays like a Harbor Band, it's something dangerous now. But he doesn't. He tempos himself out again, allowing me to draw. And that means that when I start to draw business, we are going to do stuff. We're going to have so many cards. But we need to draw land. Here's Velkin turn. And a Kraken Hatchling we don't particularly care about. So that's true, we should take out our Kraken Hatchling. And bring in Harbor Serpent. But here we are, here we go. What do we want to do? Do we want to mind rot here? I'm in no immediate danger. He did miss his land drop, right? Yes, he did. So we are getting two business cards out of his hand. Giant Scorpion Water Courser. And we're playing too slow. Bostock on tree land. Oh my god! Sands of Delirium means that we are in deep trouble. But not yet. Not yet. We can still overwhelm him. But we don't draw land. So that means that Stormtide Leviathan is not gonna see play. But now at least we can counter his threats. So if he focuses on the Sands of Delirium now, I don't think we have a chance. But if he wants to kill us with life points, we definitely have a chance. Sands of Delirium is an insane bomb here for him. And I now have 6 turns to live. need to tempo him so hard here. And he knew it and didn't attack. So I'm attacking. And Welkinton is pretty much equivalent to Windrake in this matchup. So I could play Chronomaton, Welkinton. Though a Crippling Blight will kill. No, I'm playing Windrake. Yeah. Oh, and having four turns to live now is optimistic. He needs only to draw land and then I'm dead. I'm bringing in Duress instead of Harbor Serpent to get that thing. Of course I could murder the Hatchling to do more damage in a critical turn. He's playing stuff. Oh, Mind Sculpt. So we are attacking. And now it's clearly Bloodhunter Bat. Of course, he has the Elixir as well, so we are fighting an uphill battle. Because we are dead in two turns. We have one attack phase left. If he doesn't do that, now we got two attack phases. Which of course doesn't matter at all. He doesn't realize that he just had to untap to kill me. And now I want an elixir against that thing. I need to bring in both the resses. I am bringing in the Harbor Serpent as well. Taking out the Storm Tide, the Kraken. Well, this is a truly hard thing to... That's why I like aggro decks in this format. So that way I can overrun him, but now I need to be the aggro deck in a situation where I don't really want that. I need to do it with 12 creatures as well. And being the aggro deck on the ground doesn't really help, right? And I think that's a wise sideboard, but I'm going down to 13 creatures and I think Sands of Delirium is crushing my dream here. I definitely want to play first. I need an aggressive start. This is not the aggressive start I was looking for, but I have the first turn duress, and I will need to stick with that. Spelltwine. Jesus Christ. That's where it ended up. Spelltwine and Sands of Delirium. He is not playing the fast deck. And he just has an unsummon now. That's all he has. So I'm going to sign this in blood. Because I need to put some pressure on him. But actually this is exactly what Watercourser could do here. Right? I play him, then I hit for four, hit for four. Okay, yeah, that was his second turn. So his unsummon is not gonna help a lot here. And here's a guy. No, it's divination! So I get to hit him for 4 if I want to. But I also get to play Talrand. And that's of course a horrible thing to encounter if you're a control deck. Well, now I'm not scared of sands. Big fat creature would be really nice. I am very tempted to murder anything, especially that guy. That guy looks like a great murder target, and he will of course unsummon. I wonder what he will unsummon, really. Why didn't I pump? No, okay, I did right. Yes. Okay, he can't counter the effect. So he can try to save his Death Touch guy. But he isn't doing that. Because he's killing the Drake. But the Drake is just the symptom. It's not the disease. And now I want to draw spells. We can now kiss Mr. Sky Summoner goodbye. And also that Voidstalker will deal with a lot of things. But it will not deal with Talaran's Invocation. So I need to play the Talaran's Invocation now, as I will trigger the Sky Summoner immediately, which is why he should just have used it. Why are you not using the Voidstalker? Mutilate? Oh, I thought he had a summoning sickness. I did have summoning sickness, sorry. Sorry, god damn, I thought he didn't have summoning sickness. How did that happen? Alright. Well, it's a clear case of too little too late, isn't it? Cause resolving Talaran's Invocation with Talaran in play is fairly decisive, I'd say. Did I like the sideboarding? Yes, I did. If he has Spelltwine, I definitely want to have Duress. So we are playing this again with me as the aggressor, 1-1, because of Talrand! Okay, we need to win this. This is a great starting hand. He has Mulligan to 6. We intend to crush him now. He will not be a living legend, but he will be a dead legend. And he starts the game with 5 cards. That's fantastic for us. And I think I will... Will I pump here? It's just so good to get the Walking Corpse out. But he has the Voidstalker. I can murder the Voidstalker next turn. Getting a big Chronomaton here. It's just so powerful, isn't it? And he's stuck on his lands as well. So we do murder the Voidstalker. Hit him for two. Next time we can play Windrake and Pump. Though we must not overvalue the importance of Pump against the guy who has some summons. And he didn't even want to trick me. But we have to do a lot of work before he gets going. The scorpion is okay because we know we can murder it. And now we are getting beats in. Now he has all the mana in the world. He cast another mulligan card, helping us win again. So when do we strike against the scorpion? We will attack with the chronomaton when the chronomaton is 3-3. But if we killed the scorpion now, he can spell twine, murder, mind sculpt. It's a 3-turn clock. And I think we're going for it. We are all in. This makes him less likely to draw land. And also totally screws his spell twine. Scorpion again. He only has one card in hand. So I could set up a really, really huge attack. That wasn't a good tap. Disciple of Bolas. That's pretty interesting. But we are gonna pump the chronomaton. We can do 5 cards with the shade. And that is what we're going to do if he taps out. This is why you don't play cards like Elixir of Immortality or Mind Sculpt, because those were the cards that lost him this game. Next turn I can swing with everything and he can't handle that. Not even, or maybe if he plays Wings of Uthum. But then I'm gonna Disciple, so I feel fairly confident here. Well, Right on! And his bad cards won me that game. And I am now in the final. Who am I in the final again? It's the winner of Astaroth versus G. Duncan. And I don't know anything about them. What can we estimate from their... they probably don't have black, because we have been three black decks so far. There should be a Savage Green deck out there. And a good red deck with Volcanic Geyser. Remember that, Volcanic Geyser. G. Duncan 00. G. Duncan 00 won his semifinal. And we are now in the final together. Him and I locked into a struggle to the death. And our good friend Angry Probe, who we beat in the first match, did win his second round. So we are now off to the final game. And it has been a fast tournament. My wife was coming home at 6, and I was thinking like, oh, now this is gonna go into my cuddle time with her, but it's only 10 past 5 so far, so I might be able to win a draft and then cuddle. And that is like pretty optimal, isn't it? Let's do it! Karo was my very first Magic account. This account I used to play on the beta in 2002. But Karo is apparently a sort of beans in the US, and it is a girl's name in France. So I had a lot of French people hit on me, so I figured that I would change account. In Sweden, Karo is a dog's name, and that was the intention of the account name. But getting hit on by Frenchmen was not my cup of tea, so I changed account. But I still have the account, which was great when there were the 10-year Magic Online Awards. Because this account got a full set of awards, which was sweet! Alright, G. Duncan! You ain't gonna dunk my Stormtide Leviathan. I'm gonna dunk it on you. I'm not sure what I'm saying. I'm trying to distract you while we wait. I've done poorly in Pauper today. So... whoa! But this deck wants land, so I will not be throwing back a hand like this. This has it all. And he's red, so he might be the fast red deck, in which case I don't know what this hand will do. And I will even have to discard if I sign in blood on turn 2. So do I want to do that? Cast a flunky now, I'll cast Krenko's Command. He has that arm stealer, right? I probably have to have more business. The water courser is great. Next turn, do I sign in blood? I think I do. And discard an island. Yeah, this feels decent. So now if he plays Arm Stealer, I am in so much trouble. Flank is okay. Not great, but okay. I really want the water courser to live here. So maybe I should play the Windrake. Is that greedy? Is there a way he could do 2 damage? He could play like the +1/+1 thing. It's too greedy. The water courser is not going to live. But I am greedy. God, that's how greedy I am. So now I can play the Bloodhunter Bat next turn, double block the flunkies, then play the Water Course, and then play the Disciple. Though I will be hurting. Is he on mono red? I doubt it. He will get me to 12, then to 14. Is this fast enough? Here they come. If they have a trick, it's painful, but I have to force it. No trick, but a blade tusk boar. And I think I can handle a blade tusk boar, actually. So these guys are double blocking the flunkies. I will take 4, go down to 10, play the water courser. And then be able to pump it with the Windrake as backup for the Disciple. He could kill the water courser in response, which would be horrible. Is this the correct block? I think it is. Going down fast. If he has Chandra's Fury now, it's all over. Yeah. Okay, now I am in a world of hurt. But if this water courser lives, if it has like a searing spear or anything, I'm dead. Let's make a note of the Fury. My god. That's too much. It is too much. I can't handle that. Volcanic strength. I will even get 4 lives here, but they won't save me. Nor will Talaran's Invocation. I'm not saved, right? I go to 5, I die. Okay, I can't... against a mono-red deck, I can't really dirtle around with my Stormtide Leviathan. So I'm gonna need my Duresses. I'm probably gonna need a Wild Rebirth. I definitely need Mark of the Vampire. Taking out Mind Rot. Taking out the Black Ring. Because I think I just win if the game goes long. He has the Gazer, of course. Did I have any other life gain? Is this good enough? I think it is. Playing first. Yeah, this is gonna have to do. Maybe this time I am more reluctant to throw away a card. I am definitely not gonna do that now. So he has strength, hatchling, kindled, Chandra's. And I think I need to get rid of Chandra's Fury here. Because I already have the solution to the volcanic strength, so... Hatchling is so horribly bad. Do I even... Yeah, I think I sign in blood here. Play the Hatchling. Now I really want him to play the volcanic strength. But he doesn't. And I let him happily hit me for 3. But I'm really suffering from having so many lands now. I am gonna 2-for-1 you, or at least tempo you out. Yeah, there we go. And now we're going to trade. But, yeah. Playing 18 lands has its disadvantages, and having even now sideboarded out the Stormtide. Oh my god. Okay. That could very well be game. I need to draw a murder now. Or one of my flyers, of which I have plenty. Okay, please let me get good stuff now. Well, that's a lot of good stuff, really. So he's going to 2-for-1 me. No, it's gonna be a 2-for-2. Well, I guess that is what is going to happen. It is what is going to happen. Mark of the Vampire, he really can't deal with at all. Of course, now he has the Kindle Fury, so he will kill both of them. But he's doing 6 damage if I don't do anything. So what do? I have to double block and draw it out. I should have taken it. Little did I predict the double kindled, the double volcanic strength. But it's just so much damage that I have to take it. He 2-for-1 me there, but I will 2-for-1 him when I draw my murder. All right, Talrand. All the cards I know about are out of his hand. But he's now hitting me for 7 a turn. So I probably have just this one single draw phase left. Okay. He wants to play something else. It's the battle jester. Good, because I would have been dead. Playtask boar. Well, my only chance here really is to find something useful, but I need to find 2 useful things, but that's like the only way I can win here, isn't it? So find murder and find murder, basically. It's amazing that a mono red deck could put so much pressure on me. Yeah, that's it. But I chose to play 18 land, and this is what I get. And even Stormtide Leviathan would not have saved me here. Once again, he chooses not to kill me. Okay, do I die? Yes, I die. And I'm just crushed by Mono Red. Thank you for watching Magic Energy Strat. I'm done. I was playing blue black, and yeah, that is pretty much why I don't like blue. Too slow, too dirtly in M13. If I had played green, that deck would have been nothing. Like a green and a green red deck, even a green white deck could have handled that with a bit of life gain, and a green red deck would just have laughed at it. But I didn't have those things, so I was crushed. Thank you for watching.